弟兄姐妹平安。
Peace to brothers and sisters。
感谢神的恩典，让我们能够再一次借着网络一起来思想神的话语。
We thank by the grace of God that we can come to share God's word through the internet。
在开始之前啊，有两件事情要跟大家报告。
Before we begin, we have two brief announcements。
第一件事情是啊，请大家记得要来的周末。就是11月6号到8号我们也会有一个网络的特别聚会。
So the first one is to remind the brothers and sisters that in the next weekend, the immediate weekend coming up, we will have a special meeting on the and it will be online.
郭定强弟兄要借着路德记跟我们分享恢复的道路。
Brother Timothy Quark will share with us about the recovery through the book of Ruth.
从周五到主日，我们会有四堂的信息。
From Friday to Sunday, we will have a total of four messages.
加上两堂的分组讨论。
And also including two sharing and discussion session.
详细的聚会时间和如何上网参加聚会，请大家去。参阅教会的网站。
So the details is about the time and the messages and the discussion session. Please find out the time on the church website.
如果你有需要帮助的话请跟各组的负责弟兄联络。
So if you need any help, please talk to the responsible brothers for each area.
然后第二件事情是从11月15日就是11月第三个主日开始，我们早上9:30也会有网络的播饼聚会。
So the second thing is the second announcement is that starting on November 15th, we will begin a virtual breaking of the bread, the Lord's table. It will be online as well.
详细的。聚会时间和如果上网参加聚会，也请大家参阅教会的网站。
The details of time and any other information is in the church website.
今天的报告就到此结束。
So that's all the announcement we're making today.
让我们先低头有点祷告。
Let us bow our head in prayer.
全恩主，我们实在是感谢赞美你。
Gracious Lord, we thank you and praise you.
在这疫情的当中，让我们仍然能够借着网络一起来到你的施恩宝座前。
Even though to the time of pandemic, that we can come before your mercy seat.
求主帮助我们能够真是安静在你的脚前来聆听你的话语。
Dear Lord, we pray that you calm our hearts and spirits so that we can sit at thy feet and hear your words.
也求主的圣灵帮助我们。能够更深地进入你的话语的里面。
We pray that the Holy Spirit will help us enter deeper into your words.
让我们真是对你的心意有更深的了解。
So that, Lord, we will have a greater understanding of your purpose.
也让我们有这样的心智愿意跟上你的话语。
That we will have a heart to follow after your words.
虽然在这个疫情的当中，我们不能有面对面的聚会。
Though through the pandemic, we cannot meet face to face.
也愿意主你自己的圣灵借着你的话语帮助我们在属灵上也能够有更多的追求更多的长进。
We pray that the Holy Spirit will help us so that in the spiritual matter that we will continue to seek after you and grow.
主我们真是将今天早上这一段的时间仰望在你的恩手的手中。
Lord, this morning we place the following time in your gracious hand.
求主你自己再次恩待你的众儿女。
We pray, Lord, that you be gracious unto your children.
让我们真是能够专一的注目仰望我们的恩主。
That, dear Lord, may we solely focus our attention upon you.
也让主你自己能够从天上赐下你的恩典。
We pray, Lord, that you will pour forth your blessings from heaven.
带领你的众儿女往前去。
That you will lead your children forward.
好好的跟随你的带领。
That we will follow after you faithfully.
好让主你自己的心意能够更多的成就在你的教会。
May your will be done in the church.
主，我们实在是感谢赞美你。
Lord, we thank you and praise you.
我们也再一次向你俯伏下拜。
We bow down before you and worship you.
将一切尊贵荣耀颂赞都归给你。
May all honor and praises be unto you.
我们这样祷告感谢是奉主耶稣名。
We pray all this in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
因着疫情的关系，我想从三月初开始，我们已经有七个多月的时间没有办法有面对面的聚会。
Because of the pandemic, beginning back in March, until now, we have almost 7 months of not being able to assemble together.
教会的负责弟兄也一直在衡量，在什么时候我们可以比较安全的开始恢复。我们的面对面的聚会。
The responsible brothers from the church has very often talked about and thought about how we can safely reopen the church.
我们一方面要考虑到因着疫情的关系，弟兄姐妹在疫情下的安全。
One of the things that we deeply concerned about is during the pandemic is the safety for the brothers and sisters.
另一方面，我们都是有在考虑。政府对我们就是各样聚会的建议。
And also we pay attention to what the recommendation of our government in terms of how to open up for service.
请弟兄姐妹继续为教会的恢复祷告。
We ask the brothers and sisters to please pray for the church in the opening and recovery.
求神赦免我们的罪，医治这地。
That may God forgive us of our sins and heal this land.
使疫情能够渐渐的减缓
，so that this pandemic will slowly go away。
我们也能够恢复面对面的聚会
，that once again we can assemble together。
我们知道，在这个疫情的当中在弟兄姐妹身上发生了很多的事情。
We know that through this pandemic time, there's a lot of things that are happening among the brothers and sisters。
有人失去了亲人
，some may have lost loved ones。
我们请大家为这些失去亲人的人代祷，求神安慰他们。
We ask everyone to please pray and remember and pray for those who have lost loved ones through this pandemic.
有人生病的，甚至走过了死荫的幽谷。
There are some who have suffered illnesses that maybe even to the shadow of death.
感谢神的医治和保守。
We truly give thanks to the Lord for His gracious protection and healing.
有的人已经完全康复了。
Some has completely recovered.
有的人还在康复的当中。
Some are in the midst of recovery.
请大家继续为那些还在康复当中的人代祷。
Brothers and sisters, please pray for those who are in the state of recovery at this time.
求神使他们能够快快的恢复健康。
May the Lord give them their health back.
也有的人他们的工作受了疫情的冲击。
Some must experience the distress that has to do that from the pandemic that affected their work.
甚至失去了工作。
They may have even lost their work.
请大家为那一些有工作需要的弟兄姐妹代祷。
And also please remember all these brothers and sisters in their need for work in prayer.
求神供应他们的需要。
May God provide for their needs.
有一些弟兄姐妹因着不能有面对面聚会。
And there are some brothers and sisters who are unable to assemble together face to face.
以至于就渐渐的疏懒后退。
And they may have some setback in their spiritual life.
我们也真是请弟兄姐妹我们彼此代祷。
We ask the brothers and sisters to pray for one another.
求神坚固我们每一个人的信心。
May the Lord strengthen each one of our faith.
如果我们知道有任何人需要的
，If we know of anyone that has special needs,
请大家能够尽量的去帮助他。
We ask every one of us from our own ability to try to help them.
同时也让负责的弟兄知道。
And please let the responsible brothers know as well.
这样的话，我们就可以有更多人去帮助他。
So that more people can give help to them.
真是愿意我们大家在这个疫情的当中，能够更加彼此相爱相顾。
through this pandemic time, our prayer is that we continue to strengthen our love for one another.
彼此鼓励
and encourage one another.
彼此扶持
and continue to support one another.
让我们一同在神的恩典里面度过这艰难的时期。
That through this very distressful time and difficult time, that we can be under God's grace.
我想在这个疫情的当中，所有的人都会经历到一个冲击。
We know that there is a through this pandemic time that there are all of us will suffer some sort of distress.
就是人与人之间的隔离。
And one of the things would be that we are separated from one another.
不是我们失去了与别人面对面交谈的机会。
We have lost the opportunity to have face-to-face fellowship with one another.
当有人生病的或遭遇大的变故的时候
，If someone in amidst of us suffer illnesses or serious physical condition，
我们都不太方便去看望和安慰他。
It would not be, we would not be able to go visit them and try to encourage them.
因此疫情造成了许多的不方便。
The pandemic has caused a lot of hindrance.
也使许多人感到苦闷。
And many people suffer from boredom.
虽然我们希望在明年初美国就会有那个疫苗出来。
We pray for that America will soon have the vaccine available.
可是我们知道，即使打了疫苗，我们还是需要继续维持戴口罩、勤洗手、维持社交距离这三方面的安全措施。
But we know that even with the vaccine, we're still required to have masks and make sure we wash our hands and keep a safe distance from one another.
这三方面的措施可能我们要继续维持一段的日子。
These three preventive measures, we probably will still have to continue that for quite some time to come.
可能要一年或者甚至两年。
It might be a year, it might be 2 years.
甚至更久。
Maybe longer.
我们不知道什么时候我们才能恢复完全的正常。
We really don't know when we can go back to the normal that we once knew.
有可能那过去那个我们所谓的正常的时间已经永远不再回来。
Perhaps the normal that we once knew will no longer come back to us.
我们知道在圣经里面有一个人他活在隔离的状况当中经过了一段很长的时间。
We know that in the Bible, there is a man who has been separated from people for a long, long time.
他与人隔离不是一年。
His separation was not just 1 year.
不是十年。
Not even 10 years.
而是四十年。
But it's 40 years.
我想大家都知道我讲的这个人是谁。
I'm sure you all know by now who I'm talking about.
这个人就是摩西。
This man is, the man is Moses.
我们从圣经出埃及记第三章第四章我们看见摩西经过四十年的隔离后在他身上发生了一件大事。
We know in Exodus chapter 3 and 4 that after 40 years of separation from people, something great happened in Moses' life.
这件大事完全改变了他的后半生。
And this change that happened,completely turn his whole the rest of his life around.
以前曾经跟弟兄姐妹分享过这摩西的这个经历。
We have shared many times with the brother and sister about the experiences of Moses.
那个时候因着时间的关系，有一些话没有办法详细说。
At that time, there was because of timing, we didn't finish the details.
所以今天愿意再花点时间和弟兄姐妹一起来思想这件事情。
So this morning we want to spend a little bit of time to share with our brothers and sisters on this matter.
我们先来读出埃及记第三章第一节到第五节。
We're going to read from Exodus chapter 3, verse 1 to 5.
我先来读中文，然后我们的弟兄会读英文。
I will read it in Chinese and my brother will read it in English.
出埃及记第三章第一节到第五节，摩西牧养他岳父米甸祭司叶特罗的羊群，一日领羊群往野外去，到了神的山，就是何烈山。耶和华的使者从荆棘里火焰中向摩西显现，摩西观看，不料荆棘被火烧着，却没有烧毁。摩西说：“我要过去看这大异象，这荆棘为何没有烧坏呢？”耶和华神见他过去要看，就从荆棘里呼叫说：“摩西，摩西！”他说：“我在这里。”神说：“不要近前来，当把你脚上的鞋脱下，因为你所站之地是圣地。”
And Moses kept the flock of his father-in-law Jethro, the priest of Midian. And he led the flock to the backside of the desert, and he came to the mountain of God, to Horeb. And the angel of the Lord God appeared to him in a flame of fire out of the midst of the thorn bush. And he looked, and behold, the thorn bush burned with fire, and the thorn bush was not burned up. And Moses said, I will now turn aside and see this great sight, why the thorn bush is not burned up. And the Lord God said that he has turned aside to see. God called him out of the midst of the thorn bush and said, Moses, Moses, he said, here I am. And he said, do not come near. Pull off your sandals from your feet, for the place of which you stand is holy ground.
我们看见这段经文记载了摩西那个时候在牧养他岳父的羊群。
This passage talked about the time when Moses was watching his father-in-law's flock.
有一天他带领着羊群往旷野去，就到了何烈山。
One day he took the flock out to feed and he came to Mount Horeb.
我相信摩西那个时候并不知道那个山是神的山。
Probably at that time, I believe that Moses did not know that this is the mountain of God.
他才会带领他的羊群往那个山上去。
And so that's why he would just lead his flock up to the mountain to feed.
我们看见神的使者从荆棘的火焰中向摩西显现。
We see that the angel of the Lord spoke to Moses from the burning bush.
我们从第四节知道那个耶和华的使者其实就是耶和华神自己。
And in verse 4, we can see that the Lord God is the angel that was speaking to him from the bush is actually the Lord God himself.
根据圣经学者，我们知道在何烈山的旷野那边有有常常会看到荆棘。
In studying the geography of Horeb, the scholar has told us that you can often see a thorn bush like that in Mount Horeb.
然后加上因为那个地方非常的干燥。
And because it is a very dry climate.
所以有时候荆棘就会自己烧起来。
And there are times when thorn bush actually ignite and burn by itself.
所以我相信当摩西看见那个荆棘被火烧着，应该不会太稀奇。
And so when Moses see a burning thorn bush, it wouldn't be a surprise to him.
而是因为他看到这个荆棘被火烧着，却没有烧坏。就非常的惊奇。
But what was interesting to him was that when the thorn bush was on fire, it was not consumed.
所以他要近前去看这个大异象。
That is why he moved forward to take a better look at what this great happening is.
要知道荆棘为什么没有被烧坏。
He wanted to know why the thorn bush was not consumed in the fire.
耶和华神看见摩西要过去看。
The Lord God saw Moses coming to look at the thorn bush.
就从荆棘里呼叫说，摩西，摩西。
And from the thorn bush, the Lord calls out to Moses, Moses.
我们以前说过，这是神对摩西的双重呼召。
You can see that he called him twice. This is a double calling for Moses.
在这个神对摩西的双重呼召下，神又对摩西说，不要近前来。当把你脚上的鞋脱下，因为你所站之地是圣地。
Moses responded, and God said to him, He said, "Do not come any closer. Take off the sandals from your feet, because this is holy ground."
神吩咐摩西把鞋脱下。
He had Moses remove his sandals.
一方面，那个是神所在的地方。
Because that is a place where God is.
是圣洁的。
It is holy ground.
鞋子是沾染地上的尘埃。
The sandals carries all the dust of the earth.
代表着沾染着世界的污秽。
That it will pollute the holy ground with the things of the world.
所以人到神所在的圣洁的地方，就要把世界的污秽除掉。
That's why when man come before God, he must first remove all the pollution of the world that's on him.
另一方面，我们看见在那个时候，仆人是不穿鞋子的。
And we know that at that time, the servants do not wear sandals.
所以神要他要摩西把鞋脱下。
So God wanted Moses to remove his sandals.
也预表着神呼召摩西成为神的仆人来服侍神。
It represents the fact that God has called Moses to come and be his servant.
然后接下来我们看见神就告诉摩西，他已经听见了神百姓受督工的辖制所发出的哀声。
And God tells Moses at the time that he had heard the cries of the children of God.
也知道他们的痛苦。
He knows of their suffering.
所以神就吩咐摩西去拯救神的百姓脱离埃及人的手。
Therefore, he instructed Moses to go deliver God's people from the hands of the Egyptians.
带领他们出埃及地。
He was to lead them out of the land of Egypt.
并且到神所应许那美好宽广流奶与蜜的迦南地。
That he was to lead them to the promised land of the land of milk and honey.
并且使神的百姓能够来服侍神。
So that God's people can serve God.
我们看见摩西经过何烈山上，神对他显现的这个经历后。
We see that after Moses experienced God's appearance to him on Mount Horeb,
他的人生就完全活在神的呼召下。
His whole life lives under the calling of God.
为了能够更深地体会这个经历对摩西的意义。
So to understand more about this calling in the life of Moses,
我们就需要回去看当时以色列在埃及的光景和摩西在这件事情之前的生活。
We have to return back to Egypt to see the condition of the people there and the life that Moses once had.
我们知道在出埃及记第一章那里记载着雅各在他的带着他的众子和家眷一共七十人到了埃及。
We know that in Exodus chapter 1 that Jacob took his entire family consisting of 70 people down to Egypt.
神祝福雅各一家我们在出埃及记第一章第七节到第八节那里看到说以色列人生养众多并且繁茂。极其强盛，满了那地。有不认识约瑟的新王起来治理埃及。
We see that God greatly blessed Jacob because in Exodus chapter 1 verse 7 and 8 said, and the sons of Israel were fruitful and increased very much and multiplied and became exceedingly mighty, and the land was filled with them, and there arose a new king over Egypt who did not know Joseph.
我们看见以色列人在埃及地，他生养众多，就成了有了许多的人。
We know that the children of Israel multiplied greatly into a huge number.
可是另一方面，我们看见那个时候就有一个不认识约瑟的新王起来。
And also after that, we see that a new king of Egypt has arose that did not know about Joseph.
我们知道那个时候以色列人在埃及已经快要四百年。
We know that at that time, the Israelite has been in Egypt for 400 years.
可能因为时间久远的关系使得新王不认识约瑟。
Because of the length of time, the new ruler does not know Joseph.
可是另一方面，我们从圣经学者那里知道，那个时候因为是那个旧的王朝已经被新的王所推翻。
So from history we can see that the reason for that is most likely that the dynasty of kings from the time of Joseph were overturned by a new dynasty.
所以新的王并不认识约瑟和约瑟的神。
Therefore, the new king, does not know Joseph nor his God.
新的王因为以色列人又多又强盛。
And when the king looked at and see that the Israelites has multiplied and are very strong.
所以他们很怕如果遇到他们跟敌人征战的时候，以色列人会去帮助他们的敌人来攻击他们。
So they fear that the Israelites might help their enemy if their enemy came to attack them.
并且也离开埃及。
And would leave Egypt.
所以我们知道法老就派督工去辖制以色列人，加重担苦害他们。
So the king of Egypt sent a slave master to increase the workload and persecute the Israelites.
他们那个时候为法老要建造两座的积货城。
That at that time they were going to build two cities for Pharaoh.
就是以东和南塞。
I don't know what was that.
That's in the chapter one. That's okay.
Okay.
只是埃及人越发苦待以色列人，他们就越发多起来。
And it appears that the more the Egyptian persecute the Israelite, the more they multiply.
那个时候，埃及人就因着以色列人又多又强，就非常的愁烦。
And so it became a distressing factor for the king of Egypt to see that the Israelites were multiplying.
所以法老就想了一个办法，要求希伯来的两个收生婆叫他们把以色列人所生的男孩杀掉。
So the king of Egypt, Pharaoh, had this scheme.And he brought the midwives of the Israelite to tell them that when the Israelite babies are born, they are to kill them.
但是收生婆敬畏神，就不做这样的事情，反而把男孩的性命存留下来。
But the midwives did not do what Pharaoh said. In fact, they saved the child, the male child of the Israelite.
所以法老就吩咐他的百姓自己去杀以色列人所生的男孩。
So Pharaoh instructed the Egyptian to go kill the Israelite male children.
当时摩西就在这个埃及人到处搜寻并杀害以色列人所生的男孩，这样的一个时候，他出生了。
And while this is going on, when the children of Israel were being killed, Moses was born.
当他出生的时候，他的父母看他长得俊美，就把他藏了三个月。
And when Moses was born, his parents thought that he was a beautiful child and kept him at least for three months.
后来可能他因为他哭声开始大起来了，没办法继续把他留在家里，然后就拿了一个蒲草箱，磨上石漆和石油。
So when Moses grew, his cries become louder, so they no longer can contain him. So his parents put together a basket and covered it with tar.To protect it from, or to make it waterproof, and put him in it.
然后把它放在里面，并且把箱子放在河边的芦苇的当中。
And he was placed, right next to the reeds by the bank of River Niles.
他们把孩子的性命交在神的手中。
They would put the life of their child in the hands of God.
很奇妙的，神就安排了法老的女儿。那个时候来到河边洗澡。
Amazing enough that God has arranged for Pharaoh's daughter to come with her company to take a bath in the river Nile.
并且发现那个箱子。
And they soon discover the basket.
当法老的女儿打开箱子的时候，看见那个孩子，然后孩子哭了，她就可怜那个孩子。
She opened up the daughter of Pharaoh opened up the basket and found the baby inside, and it began to cry. She was filled with compassion for it.
虽然他认出来那个孩子是希伯来人的孩子。
Though she do realize that the child is a Hebrew baby.
很奇妙的，法老的女儿并没有照法老的命令把他杀了。
Amazingly enough, that the daughter of Pharaoh did not kill this child.
反而起意要收养他。
In fact, she took him in and adopted him as a son.
那个时候，孩子的姐姐是远远的跟着。
So at that time,Moses' sister was watching and following from afar.
然后他就跑来跟法老的女儿说：“啊，我去在希伯来人妇人当中叫一个奶妈来为你奶这个孩子。”
So she approached the daughter of Pharaoh and said, "I can find amidst of the Hebrew women that there is a nurse, a wet nurse that can feed this baby for you."
然后法老的女儿就同意这个建议。
And Pharaoh's daughter agreed.
所以孩子的姐姐就去找了孩子的母亲来。
So Moses' sister went and brought his their mother to the daughter of Pharaoh.
然后法老的女儿就将这个孩子交给这个孩子的母亲，让她去奶这个孩子。
So the daughter of Pharaoh would give the child back to the mother and have her nurse the baby.
因为这个孩子是法老的女儿所收养的。
Because this child has been adopted by the daughter of Pharaoh.
所以没有一个埃及人敢来杀害这个孩子。
No Egyptian would dare to harm this child.
所以我们看到神就用这个奇妙的方法保存了这个孩子的性命。
And you can see how amazing God's work is in the protection of this child's life.
当这个孩子长大一点的时候，他的奶妈就是他的母亲，就把他带到法老的女儿那里。
When the child grew up, Moses' mother would take Moses to the daughter of Pharaoh.
然后法老女儿就收养他成为他的儿子。
And then she took him in and he became her son.
并且给这个孩子起名叫摩西，意思是因我把他从水里拉出来。
And she named him Moses because it was that she obtained this child from the water.
然后我们知道摩西就跟着法老的女儿住在皇宫的里面。
We can see that Moses would grow up in the palace of Pharaoh alongside with Pharaoh's daughter.
根据司提法在《使徒行传》七章二十二节的描述
，According to 哪一本？
斯提凡
Okay, in the books of Acts, chapter 7, verse 22, of what Stephen said.
摩西学了埃及人一切的学问，说话行事都有才能。
Stephen said, and Moses learned all the wisdom of the Egyptian and was mighty in words and deeds.
我们知道当时的埃及是从两河流域到欧洲文明最发达的国家。
And that the Egypt was well known all the way to Europe as one of the most prosperous country,
并且是最强盛的国家
and would be one of the most strongest country in the world.
我们知道在那个时代，他们所建的金字塔，到现在我们还没有办法完全了解他们在没有现代科技下怎么把金字塔造成的。
Their technology was so advanced that they have built the pyramids in Egypt, and even today, the science and technology cannot explain how they got that structure together.
摩西在法老的皇宫里不只学了埃及一切的学问。
Moses lives in Pharaoh's palace. Not only did he learn all the things of Egypt,
他也受到了在皇宫里最好的训练。
He also have the best training that you can get in the palace.
加上他的聪明才智，就使得他说话行事都显出他的才干能力。
And because of that, he has great wisdom in the things that he did and in the words that he said.
因为摩西的奶妈就是自己的母亲。
Because Moses' nurse was his own mother.
所以他知道他是一个希伯来人。
He knew he was a Hebrew himself.
所以斯提凡在《使徒行传》七章二十三节说到，摩西将到四十岁，心中起意去看望他的弟兄以色列人。
We can see also in Acts chapter 7, verse 23, Stephen continued to say, and when a period of 40 years was fulfilled to him, it arose in his heart to look upon his brothers, the sons of Israel.
然后有一天他看见一个埃及人打一个希伯来人。
So one day, when he was in the midst of them, he see an Egyptian beating an Israelite.
他左右观看，看见没有人，就把那个埃及人打死，并且藏在沙土里。
He looked around and see that no one was watching. He killed the Egyptian and buried him in the sand.
后来他看见两个希伯来人争斗，就去劝阻那个欺负人的人。
Later, he encountered two Israelites fighting against each other, and he went to talk to the person that was beating his brother.
可是那个人并不听。
The other person did not want to hear him.
反而威胁他说，谁立你做我们的首领和审判官呢？
And threatened him, saying, who had made you our leader and judge over us?
难道你要杀我像杀那埃及人吗？
Are you going to kill me like you killed the Egyptian?
我们看到在这个时候，摩西想要靠自己的力量来帮助他的同胞。
We can see that at this time, Moses has tried to help his fellow brothers and sisters in Israel by his own will.
但他的同胞不愿意听他的话。
But his brothers in Israel would not listen to him.
反而威胁他。
In fact, they threatened him.
并且法老听见这事的时候，他就想要杀摩西。
And when Pharaoh learned of this, he wanted to kill Moses.
摩西就只好逃到米甸。
The only thing Moses could do was escape out of Egypt to Midian.
在那里，他遇见了米甸祭司的女儿们。
And then in Midian, he met the priests of the Midianites and his daughters.
并且就帮助他们抵挡其他牧人的欺负。
He in fact defended the daughters from being bullied by the other people around them.
当米甸祭司的女儿们他们回去告诉他的父亲的时候，
When the daughters of the Midianite priest returned home and told their father about the incident,
他们告诉他们的父亲说，是有一个埃及人帮助了他们。
They told their father that there was an Egyptian that helped them.
然后他那个父亲就请他们去叫，让摩西去跟他们吃饭。
So the father told the daughters to go invite Moses to have a dinner or a meal with them.
后来并且把他的女儿希波拉嫁给了摩西。
And later he gave his daughter Zipporah to be married to Moses.
后来我们知道希波拉也为摩西生了两个儿子。
And later Zipporah had two sons for Moses.
然后从那个开始，摩西就牧养他岳父的羊群。
And from that day on, Moses would shepherd his father's-in-law flock.
我想那个时候摩西每天所接触的人就是他的家人。
I believe that at the time, the people that Moses encountered with will be his family members.
可是大部分的时间他是孤单的面对他岳父的羊群。
Most of the time, it will probably be just him and the flocks of his father-in-law.
在《使徒行传》七章三十节就记载着说，过了四十年，在西乃的旷野，有一位天使从荆棘火焰中向摩西显现。
In
it may not be there. Yeah.
Okay, tell me what is it again?
Yeah. 过了四十年，在西乃山的旷野，有一位天使从荆棘火焰中向摩西显现。
Okay, so after 40 years from then.The angel of the Lord appeared to Moses in Mount Horeb.
这个就是我们开始的时候在出埃及记三章第一节到第五节所读到的。
That's what we read from Exodus chapter 1 verse chapter 3 verse 1 to 5.
这个时候摩西已经在旷野 过着与人隔离的生活40年了。
And that is the time that Moses has spent in the wilderness for 40 years already.
有人或许会问说，神为什么要在这个时候才呼召摩西去拯救以色列人出埃及？
People may ask, why is it after all this time God would send Moses to deliver the Israelites?
或许也有人会问说，为什么神让摩西在旷野毫无作为的过了四十年，才呼召摩西起来服侍他？
And some may even ask, why God allowed Moses to waste his time for 40 years in the desert before calling him?
我们知道神做事是有他的计划和时间。
We all know that God's work has His own plan and His own time.
我们愿意从三方面来回答这些问题。
We're going to answer this question from three aspects.
第一方面，我们根据出埃及记12:40-41所记载的，我们知道以色列人住在埃及共有430年，正满了430年那一天，耶和华的军队从埃及地出来了。
So, the first is in Exodus chapter 12, verse 40 to 41. At the time that the son of Israel lived in Egypt was 430 years. And it happened at the end of the 430 years, it was on this very day, all the armies of the Lord God went out from the land of Egypt.
另外，出埃及记12:37也记载着说，以色列人从兰塞起行往苏哥去，除了妇人孩子，步行的男人约有60万。
So in Exodus chapter 12, verse 37, it tells us that the numbers, which is, and the sons of Israel journeyed from Ramses to Succoth, the men being about 600,000 men on foot apart from the little ones.
所以我们看见以色列人在埃及地住了一共有430年。
We know that the Israelites had lived in Egypt for 430 years.
当他们进去的时候只有70个人。
When they went there, it was 70 of them.
可是当他们出埃及的时候，男人约有60万。
When they left Egypt, only counting the male, there were 600,000 men.
所以换句话说，以色列人在当时可能有100多万人。
And you can see from that, most likely that the Israelites were over 1 million in population when they left Egypt.
神让雅各一家人在埃及这个回窝的地方住了430年。
And God will let Jacob and his family live in this fertile land of Goshen in Egypt for 430 years.
因为没有敌人的攻击。
And there were no attack from their enemies.
就使他们从70个人生养众多变成100多万人。
And they would grow from 70 people to over 1 million.
所以这样他们才能成为耶和华的军队去征服迦南地。
And they now has become the army of the Lord God of hosts that will come to conquer the land of Canaan, where it is the land of milk and honey.
这是耶和华为什么要等到这个时候才差遣摩西去带领以色列人出埃及的第一个原因。
This is the first reason why God would lead the Israelites out of Egypt at this time.
因为神不只是要拯救他的百姓脱离埃及为奴之地。
It is because that not only God wants to deliver the Israelites from slavery in Egypt,
并且神也要带领他们去征服神所应许的迦南美地。
But he was going to lead them into the promised land of Canaan to conquer it.
因为在这个时候，以色列人才有足够的人力。
Only at this time that there is enough manpower in the nation of Israel to do it.
使他们能够靠着神的帮助，不只是能够打败迦南地的人。
By the help of God, not only will they defeat the Canaanites,
并且也能够有足够的人能够占领迦南地。
But they will have enough people to settle in the land of Canaan.
因为神是全知的。
God is an all-knowing God.
他知道什么时候应该要做什么事情。
He knows exactly when to do things.
使得他全备的计划能够照他的时间啊来完成。
And his complete plan will be fulfilled in his time.
所以我们在这一方面我们可以学一个功课。
And in this we can learn a lesson.
就是虽然我们不知道我们前面的道路是如何。
That though we live in life that we don't know what is ahead of us.
但是因为我们相信神的智慧、能力和恩典。
But because we believe in the power of God, the wisdom of God, and the grace of God.
我们就可以放心地将我们自己交在神的手中。
That we can safely place our life in the hands of God.
让神来带领我们往前去。
That let God lead us.
第二方面，我们看见在埃及这个生活物质丰富的环境下。
Secondly, we can see that though in Egypt the life is full for them and sufficient for them.
要叫以色列离开这个舒适并且熟悉的环境，去到一个对他们来说已经是比较陌生的迦南地，是不太可能的事。
So to get them out of their comfort zone in Egypt to go to a foreign land that they're not familiar with would not be an easy thing for them.
我们看见即使他们已经出了埃及到了旷野然后遇到了一些比较艰困的环境的时候他们所发的怨言。
And we can see that when they left Egypt and went into the wilderness and when they encounter trouble and difficulty,They start to complain.
我们来看民数记十一章四到六节所记载以色列人在埃及地所的在旷野的时候的抱怨。
So let's look at Numbers chapter 11 verse 4 to 6 and see the complaint of the Israelite in the wilderness.
他们中间的闲杂人大起贪欲的心，以色列人又哭嚎说：“谁给我们肉吃呢？我们记得在埃及的时候。”不花钱就吃鱼，也记得有黄瓜、西瓜、韭菜、葱、蒜。现在我们的心血枯干了，除了这玛拿以外，在我们眼前并没有别的东西。
Listen to what they say. And the mixed multitude in their midst lusted with great lust, and the son of Israel also turned and wept and said, Who shall give us flesh to eat?We remember the fish which we ate freely in Egypt, the cucumbers and the melons and the leeks and the onions and the garlic. But now our soul is dried away. There's nothing at all beside this manna before our eyes.
我们知道在以色列人在旷野不是没有东西吃。
We know that the Israelite was not starving in the wilderness.
神每天从天上赐给他们足够吃饱的玛拿。
That God would have gave them sufficient manna from heaven to fill them.
玛拿的颜色是白的，并且味道滋味如同掺着蜜的薄饼。
So the manna is white in color, and it has the taste of like honey in it.
神也是给他们烟吞吃和水喝。
And they would drink from the river.
可是因为食物的种类的缺乏
，But because of the lack in varieties of food,
他们就想起在埃及的时候，他们有那个食物的丰富。
They will return back to them. That memories will return back to Egypt and thought about the abundance of Egypt.
而向神抱怨
，and start to complain against God.
神知道人都是贪图生活的安逸。
He knows that man will often has the greed and lust for the material things.
他们不会主动放弃一个舒适并且熟悉的生活环境。
They would not give up a comfortable and familiar life and surrounding that they are in.
所以我们看见神就要兴起一个新的王。来苦待他们。
And that is why God allowed a different king to come into power in Egypt to persecute them.
然后我们也真是看见经过了多年以后，虽然他原来的埃及王死了。
So we can see that after many years, the original king of Egypt died.
可是埃及人对于以色列人的逼迫并没有减轻。
And the persecution by the Egyptian was not lessened.
反而更重。
It became even more so.
所以他们就哀叹息哀求神。
So they groaned and cried out to God.
神也听啊，神听见他们的哀声。
And God heard their cries.
就纪念他与亚伯拉罕、以撒、雅各所立的约。
And God remembered the covenant that He made with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
神不只知道他们所遭受的痛苦。
God not only know of the suffering they experienced there.
也知道他们的痛苦已经大到一个地步，使得他们会愿意听从神借着摩西对他们所说的话。
But their suffering it has become so great that they are at this point willing to hear what God has to say.
使他们愿意离开这富裕的地方，去神所应许的迦南地。
That they would leave even though abundant in Egypt and they would go to the land of Canaan.
这个是神要等到这个时候才差遣摩西去带领以色列人出埃及的第二个原因。
第一个，is it 第一个 ？Did you say 第一个？
第二个，第二个 ，second reason.
Sorry, okay.、Yeah. So this is the second reason, and the second aspect that we look at on why God uses time, to have Moses lead them out of Egypt.
我想我们在这里啊、也是可以学一个功课。
We can learn a lesson here.
有时候我们一个在一个环境太安逸也熟悉。
Then when we are in a comfortable, familiar surrounding ourselves,
以至于我们不愿意放弃这个安逸熟悉的环境，跟随主的带领往前去。
And we will resist and even reject God's leading us out of our comfort zone and of ours.
所以神有时候就会兴起一些艰难的事情。
And God would at time cause difficult things to arise in our life.
逼我们必须离开我们所熟悉安逸的环境。
And we would be forced to leave our familiar and comfortable surroundings.
然后往前去。
And then move forward.
像我们看见主耶稣在使徒行传一章八节应许他的门徒说，圣灵要降临在他们的身上。
In Acts chapter 1, the Lord Jesus promised the disciples that the Holy Spirit will shall descend upon them.
他们就必要得着能力。
And they shall receive power.
并且要在耶路撒冷、犹太全地和撒玛利亚直到地极做主的见证。
And they shall bear witness to him from Jerusalem to Samaria and to the ends of the earth.
但是我们看见在五旬节圣灵降临在门徒身上后，
We see that at the time of Pentecost, that the Holy Spirit descended upon the disciples.
然后他们就得着能力，能够带领许多人来信主。
They received the power to lead many to the Lord.
可是他们大部分人就留在耶路撒冷。
But most of them remained in Jerusalem.
并没有向外面去传福音。
They did not went out to preach the gospel.
所以神就允许大逼迫临到耶路撒冷。
So God brought persecution into Jerusalem.
不只是斯提凡为主殉道。
Not only was Stephen martyred for God.
并且除了使徒以外，大部分的门徒就分散往犹太和撒玛利亚各城去。
The apostles and the rest of the disciples were scattered out of Jerusalem into the land of Samaria.
那些分散的人就到各处去传道。
And they all went about their places preaching the gospel.
腓力也往撒玛利亚去。
Philip went towards Samaria.
然后在那里传讲基督。
And he would preach the gospel about Christ.
结果福音就传到了撒玛利亚，使许多人信了主。
And the gospel reached the Samaritan, and many people believe in the Lord.
另一方面，有对于有一些还没有信主的人
，and many went to those who had not yet known the Lord.
因为常常他们觉得他们现在的生活过得很好
，and sometimes people think that their lives are pretty well off.
他们并不需要主耶稣
，and they have no need of the Lord Jesus.
所以有时候我们看见主耶稣为了爱他们。
And we see that when at a time because the love of the Lord for them.
为了要拯救他们。
Because he wants to save them.
有时候也会让一些大难处临到他们的身上。
And he would bring difficulty in, or he would let difficulty come into their lives as well.
把他们逼到走投无路的地步。
And they will be forced into a corner where they have nowhere to go.
使得他们不得不服下来。
That forces them to bow down before the Lord.
来寻求主耶稣的帮助。
And to seek His help.
我们看见主耶稣在那个时候也会照着他的应许。
And the Lord Jesus will do as He has promised.
说你们祈求就给你们。
Then when you ask, it shall be given to you.
寻找就寻见。
Seek and you shall find.
叩门就给你们开门。
Knock and then the door shall be opened to you.
我们看见主耶稣会赐下足够的恩典。
The Lord will give enough grace.
带领他们度过难处。
To lead them out of their distress and trouble.
让他们经历主的恩典和信实。
That they will be able to experience the faithfulness and the blessing of the Lord.
使他们回转过来，来相信接受主耶稣。
So that they can turn to the Lord.
也使他们学习怎样依靠神的恩典来过他们的生活。
That they will learn to live in the and rely on the blessing of the Lord to live.
所以当我们在遭遇难处的时候
So therefore when we encounter troubles.
我们要知道不是主不爱我们。
We must understand that it is not because the Lord doesn't love us.
而是主要借着难处逼我们回转来归向他。
But rather, through the difficulties and troubles that we can turn back to the Lord.
让我们带领我们能够进入他的心意的里面。
That we can be led into His will.
能够在他的里面享受他的恩典。
That we can enjoy His blessing.
第三方面，我们在前面说过。
Thirdly, we said before.
摩西不只是学了埃及人一切的学问
，that Moses not only have learned all the academics of Egypt，
他也受了最好的训练
，he had all the better training of everything else，
因此使得他说话行事都有才能
，and that's why he was skilled in terms of the things that he said and in the things that he did。
这个时候的摩西一定非常的自负。Self-confident.
And at this point, Moses is very self-confident.
并且应该会有雄心大志。
And he would have great intention to do. He would have intention to do great things.
并且他可能要想要做一番大事。
And he would want to do that.
所以他才会去想要靠自己的才能来帮助他的同胞。
And he was going to use his own ability to help his brother, his fellow man.
但他失败了。
But he failed.
不但的他的同胞拒绝他
Not only did his fellow man rejected him.
并且使他成为一个杀人的逃犯
He became a murderer and a criminal on the run.
他需要离开那富丽堂皇的埃及王宫
Then he now have to leave the glorious palace of Egypt.
孤单的流落到了米甸的旷野
And run off to loneliness.In the wilderness of Midian.
我们前面说过，当米甸祭司的女儿们看见摩西的时候，她看他是一个埃及人。
When we can remember that when the priests of Midian, daughters saw Moses, what they saw was an Egyptian.
我们知道埃及在圣经的里面是预表着世界。
In the Bible, we know that Egypt is a representation of the world today.
所以当摩西逃到米甸的时候，在人的眼中，他是一个充满埃及的人。
So when Moses escaped to Midian, people looked at him and know that he is full of Egypt in him.
他是一个属于世界的人。
He is a person of the world.
我们知道神不能用一个靠自己的才干来做事的人。
But we know that God would not use someone who would rely only on himself to do things.
神也不能用一个属于世界的人。
And God would not use one who is of the world.
因为这样的人他不会照着神的心意来服侍神。
Because such a person will not do according to God's will and serve him.
就会打乱了神的计划。
And he will cause trouble in God's plan.
我们知道在创世纪十六章记载了一件事情。
In Exodus chapter 16, it said this.
亚伯兰的妻子撒来因为自己不能生孩子。
Abram's wife Sarah is unable to have children.
就和亚伯兰商量。
So she discussed with Abram.
把自己的使女夏甲给亚伯兰做妾。
She would give Haggai her handmaid to be a concubine for Abram.
结果亚伯兰在86岁的时候生下了以实玛利。
And at 88 years old, Abram had a son, Ishmael.
结果神到亚伯兰99岁的时候才又对他说话。
And God did not speak to Abram until he was 99 years old, and he spoke to him again then.
因为以实玛利不是神应许要给亚伯兰的后裔。
Because Ishmael was not the promised descendant that God was going to give to Abram.
并且我们也看到以实玛利的后裔就是现在的阿拉伯人。
And we can see that the descendant of Ishmael are the Arabians of today.
到现在都还跟以色列人一直为敌。
And they continue to be the enemy of the Israelite even to today.
并且要消灭以色列国。
They want to destroy the nation of Israel.
所以我们看到这个时候实在是神还不能用摩西。
We can see that at that time, God could not use Moses either.
神需要操练摩西。
God would need to train and discipline Moses.
使得摩西能够完全的放下自己。
So that Moses can put aside himself completely.
降服在神的脚前。
And then willingly submit at the feet of God.
完全照着神的心意来为神做事。
And obedience to God's will to do what God wants him to do.
可能摩西的才干实在是太大了。
Perhaps Moses' talent was very great.
所以神要用40年的时间用隔离的生活来操练他。
And that's why God had to use 40 years to separate him from his world to train him.
使他不再依靠自己的才干能力。
So that he would no longer depend on his own talents and his skills.
而是完全依靠神。
But solely rely on the Lord.
我们看见在出埃及记三章十一节那里记载，当神告诉摩西神要打发他去见法老的时候。
We see that in Exodus chapter
3 verse 11.
Chapter 3, verse 11, God was going to send Moses to talk to Pharaoh about setting free the sons of Israel.
摩西对神说，我是什么人，竟能去见法老，将以色列人从埃及领出来呢？
And Moses said to God, who am I that I should go to Pharaoh and that I should bring forth the sons of Israel out of Egypt?
40年前摩西觉得他可以靠自己的才能做以色列人的领袖和审判官。
40 years ago, Moses thought that he was qualified to be the judge and leader of Israel.
现在却看自己是一个没有用的牧羊人。
Now he looked at himself as useless and nothing but a shepherd.
他怎么能够去看世界最在那个时候世界上最伟大的王呢？
How can he go see the greatest king of the world at the time?
所以我们看见神就应许摩西说，神必与他同在，他可以依靠 神去见法老。
And so God promised Moses that he will be with him, and he can trust him that he will be there with him to talk to Pharaoh.
像在出埃及记第四章第十节那里记载说，摩西对耶和华说：“主啊，我数日是不能言的人，就是从你对仆人说话以后也是这样。我本是走口笨舌的。”
And Moses said in verse 10 of chapter 4, Moses said to the Lord God and said, "Oh my Lord, I am not a man of words, nor now, nor since you have spoken to your servant, but I am slow of speech and slow of tongue."
我们看见摩西原本是一个说话行事都有才能的人。
We see that originally Moses was very talented and skilled in speaking.
但现在他觉得自己是数日不能言的人。
Now he confessed that he is not a man of any words.
本是拙口笨舌的。
He is slow in speech and have a slow tongue.
所以神就告诉他是神是世人说话能力的神。
But God reminded him that God is the one who can speak and has the power to speak.
他可以放心的去，因为神必赐他口才，指教他所当说的话。
He can be at peace to go speak for the Lord because God will help him speak his words.
并且我们看见神也让他的哥哥亚伦替摩西向百姓说话。
And God would let his brother Aaron to speak for Moses to the Israelites.
所以我们看见在这个时候摩西已经是一个不再依靠自己能力的人。
We can see that Moses no longer rely on himself to do things.
他是完全依靠神。
He solely rely on God.
并且他也相信神。
And he trusts in God.
他就照着神的吩咐去埃及。
And he, in obedience, he went to Egypt.
开始神所吩咐他拯救以色列人脱离埃及为奴之地的使命。
And begin his mission of delivering the Israelite from the land of Egypt.
并且他也带领以色列人能够进入神所应许牛奶与蜜的迦南地。
And he would lead the people of God into the land of milk and honey.
我想这个是神要等到这个时候才差遣摩西去带领以色列人出埃及的第三个原因。
And I believe this is the third reason why God at this time would use Moses to deliver the Israelite out of Egypt into the promised land.
我们看见神从摩西出生就开始看顾保守带领他。
We see that God kept and watched over Moses since the day he was born.
神不但借着法老的女儿收养他，保存了他的性命。
He not only used the daughter of Pharaoh to keep his and protected his life,
并且让他学了埃及一切的学问,
but also allowed him to learn all the knowledge of Egypt,
使他说话行事都有才能,
so that when he speak and do things, he will have great talent and skill.
虽然这个时候他想靠自己的才干来帮助他的同胞。
And though at the time he wanted to use his ability to help his fellow man,
结果使得他不但成为杀人的逃犯。
With that, he not only became a criminal and a murderer,
连他想要帮助的同胞都拒绝他。
That even,The fellow man that he tried to help rejected him.
可是经过40年的隔离生活,
But after 40 years of separated life,
神从那颗被火焚烧却没有被烧毁的荆棘里呼召了他,
And God will call him from the unconsumed burning bush,
让他来服侍神,
And allow him to serve God.
从此就完全改变了摩西的人生。
And from that time, Moses' life was completely changed.
那颗被火焚烧却没有烧毁的荆棘。
The thorn bush that were burned and was not consumed,
就预表了神在摩西身上所要成就的那个恩典的作为。
represents God's graciousness in Moses' life.
我们知道从创世纪第三章十八节到十九节，我们知道荆棘是人犯罪以后地才长出来的。
The thorn bush that is set here is that it reminded us that the thorn bush did not appear until after men fall from the grace of God.
是神用来惩罚人的。
It is used to punish mankind.
所以荆棘在圣经里面常常就预表了那些所有的在亚当犯罪以后所有的人。
Therefore, the thorn bush represents all the sinners since the day of Adam.
在亚当犯罪以后，所有每一个人都活在罪的辖制下。
That everyone after Adam sinned will be under the constraint of sin.
不断的犯罪得罪神。
They will continue to sin against God.
我们知道另一方面，火在圣经当中是代表着审判。
We know that fire represents judgment.
通常荆棘被火烧了以后就会被烧毁。
We know that if the thorn bush is on fire, it will eventually be consumed.
预表所有的人将来在神的审判下，因着我们的罪，都要被扔在烧着硫磺的火湖里。
It is to tell us that someday we all will be judged for our sins, and we shall be condemned in the fire of hell, and will be consumed in it.
在那里永远受痛苦。
There we will perish and will suffer through all eternity.
但是我们看见在这个异象中
，But we can see from this vision,
荆棘被火烧着却没有烧毁。
That the thorn bush, though on fire, was not consumed.
就预表着神虽然要审判所有的人
，It represents the fact that God will indeed pass judgment on all mankind.
但神爱所有的人
，But God loves man.
就借着他的儿子为人预备了救恩
，And through His Son, He gives them salvation.
使人靠着神儿子的代赎
，That if man would rely on the atoning work of his son,
人的罪就可以得到神的赦免。
Then the sin of man will receive forgiveness.
使人不会落入永远的灭亡。
That he will no longer perish.
另一方面，火在这里事实上也代表着神的荣耀。
The fire also represents the glory of God.
神不只是要在人的身上做拯救的工作。
That God does not only want to do the salvation work in man's life,
使人不是落入那永远的灭亡
so that he will not perish.
神更要在人的身上做工
But God wants to do more work in the life of man.
神要借着环境和事情来破碎他们
through the environment to the surrounding condition that God will break them.
并且要改变他们
，and change them，
在他们身上做建造的工作
，and rebuild their lives，
并且也高抬他们
，and exalt them，
使得他们能够服侍神
，so that they can come to serve God，
有一天能够成为一个能够承接神荣耀的器皿
，that one day they will be a vessel that can truly hold the glory of God，
也能彰显神的荣耀
，and manifest the glory of God。
就像那一颗在火里火焰中的荆棘，却没有被在火焰中没有被烧毁的荆棘。
Just like the thorn bush that was on fire, but it was not consumed.
像摩西虽然是一个杀人的逃犯
，though Moses was a murderer and a criminal on the run,
但神没有弃绝他。
But God did not reject him.
表面上好像摩西在旷野浪费了四十年。
It may appear that Moses wasted 40 years of his life in the wilderness.
但事实上，神在那40年当中，在摩西身上做破碎的工作。
But it is in this 40 years, God would have broken Moses in the wilderness.
使摩西不再依靠自己。
So that Moses no longer rely and depend on himself.
而能够完全的依靠神。
That he would totally depend on God.
并且照着神的心意来服侍神。
And that he would serve God according to God's will.
我们看见当摩西带领以色列人出埃及后，
We see that when Moses led the Israelites out of Egypt,
在旷野的四十年当中，
In the 40 years that they spent in the wilderness,
每次遇到事情，
Every time they encounter trouble,
神就把这件事情带到神的面前，寻求神的带领。
And Moses would bring these matters before God to seek God's leading in the matter.
我们看见神在山上把会幕的样式指示了摩西。
We see that God gave Moses the pattern of the tabernacle on the mountain.
我们前面说过，摩西学了埃及一切的学问。
We have read before.That Moses had learned of the knowledge of Egypt.
埃及人在那个时候已经知道怎样建造金字塔。
And at that time, the Egyptians already know how to build structures like the pyramids.
所以摩西也应该学会了埃及一切的建筑技术。
And so Moses would have learned the architectural techniques of Egypt.
所以当摩西在照着神的命吩咐在那建造会幕的时候
，And so when Moses built the tabernacle in accordance to God's pattern that was given to him，
如果摩西有一点点想要靠自己的才干的想法
，And if Moses dared to use his own talent，
他就会在建造会幕的事情上加添自己的意见
，He would put his own ideas。Into how to build the tabernacle.
但是我们看见摩西是完全照着神在山上的指示的样式把会幕建造起来。
But we can see that the Bible tells us that Moses built the tabernacle in accordance to the pattern that God showed him on the mountain.
当人攻击摩西的时候
，And when people attack Moses,
他并不为自己辩护。
He would never have to defend himself.
他就仰望神。自己来处理这样的一个情况
，and he would let God deal with the situation at hand。
所以，我们看见圣经在民数记十二章第三节说到摩西，说摩西为人极其谦和，胜过世上的众人。
That's why God said in Numbers chapter 12 verse 3, he said, "Now that Moses was very meek, more than all the men on the face of the earth."
所以并且神也知道神是怎样忠心的在那里服侍神。
God knows that Moses will serve him faithfully.
所以神在民数记十二章七节那里称赞摩西说：“我的仆人摩西不是这样，他是在我全家尽忠的。”
And God praised Moses in chapter 12 verse 7, saying, "Not so, my servant Moses; he is faithful in all my house."
我们看见在最后摩西快要离世之前
，And in the last day before Moses died，
在申命记三十章第一节那里称他为神人摩西。
In Deuteronomy chapter 33 verse 1， Moses is called the man of God。
神人是指一个能够完全活在神心意的人。
What does it mean to be the man of God? It is a person who lives.Totally and completely in the will of God.
因此他能够把神的心意带给人。
That he will also be able to bring God's will to men.
也能够活出神的荣美来。
And he will be able to live out the beauty of God in him.
使人看见他就仿佛看见了那荣耀的神。
And when people see him, they will actually see the glorious God.
我们看见摩西在神的手中从一个杀人的逃犯
，We can see that Moses began with life as a man, as a murderer and a criminal.
是一个属于世界的人。
He was a man of the world.
但是他在神的手中被神所破碎和建造。
But in the hands of God, God has broken him and rebuilt him.
不只成为一个忠心。服侍神的仆人
，Not only is he a faithful and loyal servant of God，
最后更变成一个能够把神的心意带给人
But he will turn into a man that can bring God's will to them.
能够彰显神荣耀的神人。
And he can manifest the glory of God as the man of God.
像那一颗焚而不毁的荆棘所预表的。
Just like the unconsumed thorn bush that will burn.
神在摩西上所做的。
In the life of Moses, God has done.
也是神希望能够在每个人身上所做的。
It is the same thing that God wants to do in the life of all of us today.
不论原来我们是怎样的人。
It doesn't matter what we were before.
我们都是活在罪里的人。
We all are one who dwell in sins.
可能我们说我们不会犯什么大罪。
Though we can claim that we did not sin great sins.
可是如果我们自己反省的时候。
But if we truly look deeper into ourselves.
我们会发现我们实在是小罪不断。
But we can see that our sins, as small as they are, but they are constant.
因着我们的罪，我们将来的结局就是被扔在烧着硫磺的火湖里。
But because of our sins, we will be condemned and be burned forever in the sulfur lake of fire.
永远在那里受苦。
There we will suffer through all eternity.
神因着神爱我们。
But because God loves us,
他已经借着他儿子耶稣基督在十字架上的死
，through the death of His beloved Son Jesus Christ our Lord,
为我们预备了救赎
，that He had through that He prepared the salvation grace.
只要我们愿意接受神的救恩
，as long as we accept His salvation,
我们就相信耶稣基督。
And believe in the Lord Jesus.
我们就可以免去那落入啊永远灭亡的结局。
That by that we will not have to perish.
可是神不要我们仅仅得救。
But God does not just want us to be barely saved.
神更愿意在我们身上做工。
He is willing to do more work in our lives.
破碎我们，建造我们。
Break us and continue to build us up.
使我们能够成为神的仆人。
So that we can be a servant of God.
照着神的心意，忠心的来服侍神。
It will be a servant that will do according to His will faithfully and loyally.
并且有一天，我们也能够成为一个能够承接神荣耀的器皿。
That someday we will be a vessel that can hold the glory of God.
若有人还没有相信耶稣。
And if you have not believed in the Lord Jesus,
希望你们能够好好的思想你现在的光景。
Our prayer is for you to truly think about your condition now.
回转过来。
And turn around.
来相信耶稣基督。
And believe in Jesus Christ.
来接受神所为我们预备的这个救恩。
And receive the salvation grace that God has richly prepared for us.
并且走上那像摩西所走的路。
And we will follow the path of Moses.
在神的手中能够被改变。
That in the hands of God, our lives shall be changed.
将来也能够像摩西一样被神所称许。
That someday we shall be like Moses, that we shall be praised by our God.
或许在我们当中也有一些人已经相信了主。
Perhaps some of you have already believed.
但是还在这个救恩的路上，在那里游荡的。
And you are hesitating in this path of salvation.
愿我们彼此勉励。
Let us encourage one another.
让我们能够更多的体会神在我们身上的心意。
That we have come together to have a greater understanding of God's will.
从今天开始就将我们自己交在神的手中。
Beginning today, we are to place our lives in God's hand.
让神在我们身上做那奇妙改变的工作。
May He do amazing changing work in our lives.
让我们能够在今天能够好好的忠心的照神的心意来服侍神。
That beginning today, that we shall loyally and faithfully serve our Lord.
将来也能够欢欢喜喜的被神带入他的荣耀的国度里面。
And we shall rejoice when He comes to take us into heaven with Him.
好，我想我们今天的分享就停在这里。
We'll stop our sharing here today.
我们低头再有一点祷告。
Let us bow our head in prayer.
主，我们实在是感谢赞美你。
Lord, we thank you and praise you.
你让我们借着你在摩西身上所做的
，through the work that you have done in Moses' life.
主，让我们能够更多的明白你的心意。
The Lord, may we understand more of your will and purpose.
主，让我们真是能够看见主，你不只是要我们。要把我们从罪中拯救出来。
Lord, let us see that not only do you want to deliver us from our sins,
主，你更要在我们身上做那荣耀的工作。
That you want to do glorious work in our lives,
让我们能够成为从一个原本是不配服侍你的人。
That from a person that was unworthy to serve you,
经过你手的破碎和建造。
From you breaking and rebuilding us,
让我们能够成为一个能够配得服侍你的仆人。
That we shall indeed be one worthy of serving you.
让我们也能够忠心的照着你的心意来服侍你。
May we serve you faithfully and loyally.
也使我们真是能够被改变，从一个卑贱的器皿，成为一个能够承接你荣耀的器皿。
Then in thee, Lord, we shall grow from a common vessel to a noble vessel that will be useful for you.
让神你能够借着我们来彰显主你自己的荣美。
Then in thee, Lord, we shall contain your beauty in us.
也让人能够看见主你是何等的荣耀。
That allows others to see how glorious you are, Lord.
主，我们知道这都是你在我们身上所要成就的那荣耀的工作。
We know, Lord, that you want to do this glorious work in our lives.
愿我们真是能够好好的跟上去。
We pray, Lord, that we will faithfully follow after you.
让我们每个人真是能够成为一个合你心意、讨你喜悦的儿女。
May we be one that is fit for you and be pleasing unto you.
也让你的旨意、你的心意能够成就在我们的身上。
May your will be done in our lives.
主，我们感谢赞美你，你是这样的恩待我们。
We thank you and praise you, Lord, for being so gracious to us.
也愿意在我们身上真是做那奇妙的工作。
That, Lord, you do such wonderful work in our lives.
主，我们真是愿意再一次向你俯伏下拜。
Lord, we bow down before you and worship you.
也再一次将一切的尊贵荣耀颂赞归给你。
May all honor and praises and glory be unto you.
我们将祷告感谢是奉主耶稣名。
We pray all this in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.